Hey everybody, welcome to the Kingdom of Yahweh Online Ministries, where we make Jesus number one in our lives, and where we preach the real deal. God bless you all. Thanks for being here for me, for following Jesus and us here at Kingdom of Yahweh Online Ministry. Last time I did a video, we were in Revelations, and we left off at the end of chapter 7. We're going to start back up in Revelation chapter 8. So if you got your Bibles ready, you know, get them out there, the sword. You have to have that sword in order to defeat the enemy. There's power in the Word of God. There's power in the name of Jesus. But first, under the guidance and direction of Jesus Christ, my Lord, because, you know, He tells me what to do, where to go, what to say. It's the Holy Ghost inside of me that does these things. And I got a special song tonight for those that are bound by drugs and alcohol. You know, alcohol and drugs, addiction is addiction. It's all the same thing. And I just want to tell you all, because this is the real deal. And nobody's got no props and no makeup, no do-overs. This thing goes in like it was made right now, like it's going in today and all the other ones. There was a time in my life when I was a drug addict. And that's right, Preacher Michael was a drug addict. Oh, I told every lie in the book. I played every con game there was on my friends, on my family. I hurt them all deeply. So much so that they turned away from me. Changed their telephone numbers and just discarded me, because that's just what happens when you live for the devil and you're walking and playing in the devil's field and playground. That's right, I was delivered. I was delivered by Jesus because I got tired. I got tired of being without the love of my family. I got tired of being looked at as some junkie drug addict that all he does is beg for money. I got tired of people crossing the street when they saw me walking down the other sidewalk because they didn't want me to ask them for money. I got tired of people looking down on me, but we're not supposed to judge, but they do. They judge. It doesn't matter, because Jesus set me free. And those of you out there that are bound by alcohol and drugs right now, all you gotta do is ask Jesus to help you, to deliver you from the alcohol and the drugs. All you gotta do is ask Jesus to save you, to fill you with the Holy Ghost. All you gotta do is ask Jesus to bring your family back into the picture, to forgive you of all your sins, to cast it behind you into the sea of forgetfulness, and to heal your family's hearts that you have so horribly hurt. I got my family back because Jesus gave them back to me. Why? Because He delivered me, and I became the man that I really was before I allowed Satan to consume me with the drugs. I want to play this song for all you people out there that are addicted and are fighting that battle, because I know it's a battle. If anybody knows, it's me. Preacher Michael knows it's a battle. It's a great battle, one that most of us are fighting and have fought. So this song here, you know, and I don't care about copyright infringements, because YouTube told me it was okay to play this music, because, you know, let them make the money on the video. I don't care about money, as everybody knows here. I don't ask anybody for any money. What I do ask that you go to YouTube, subscribe to the Lord's channel, it's under my name, and that you become a member of the Jesus People community, from the Heart of God community, my Google Plus page, and Wendy's Google Plus page, Wendy Goodrum at Google Plus, Michael Anthony Correccia at Google Plus. We also have a collection page, which is the Chosen Work of Jesus and the Love of Jesus collection pages. Just come on over there and join and be a member. You can post on the Jesus People as long as it's got to do with Jesus. There's several categories there, the same with the From the Heart of God community. There's categories where you can post and join in on the fun and join in on helping us to reach the lost and the deceived. Someone have Sister Wendy put on this song by Graham Brown, which touched my heart tremendously, and the Lord moved on me and told me to use it. X that out right there, Sister Wendy, and go ahead and start the song. Just hang on, bear with me a minute. We're gonna go into the worship. We're gonna lift our hands up to our Father Yahweh and Jesus, because they're worthy to be praised. They're worthy to worship. They're worthy to serve. They're waiting for you to call on them and come into your life, into your heart. They are there. They're there right now next to you. You're not alone. If you think you're alone, you're wrong. Because Jesus is right there. Yahweh is right there. All-knowing, all-powerful God. The Almighty God of the Hebrews and His Son Jesus, Yahshua. They're right there. Yahweh and Yahshua are right there. Jesus of Nazareth. So don't feel like you're alone. All you got to do is open that heart to them, and they will come in and change you. They'll start changing you from the inside, and they work their way out. Well, the devil starts changing you from the outside and works his way in into your heart and corrupts it. You want to ask Jesus to give you a new heart, to give you a spirit that will please him, a pure heart like King David had. Yahweh said that David, the king of Israel, was a man after his own heart. That's what I want. I want to be a man after the heart of Yahweh, our Father, our God. I want to be about the Father's business all the time, because that's what I was sent here to do. In all them years that I boggled and was buried down in the drugs, they passed by so fast. Before I knew it, 20 years have gone by, and there I was in the same state of mind, addicted and broke. It was horrifying, standing in food lines. You ain't got to do that. Looking for a place that I could lay my head, whether it was under bushes, under overpasses. That's right. Preacher Michael was there. And Preacher Michael could tell you that Jesus set me free from it all and gave me a beautiful place to live, a nice car to drive, set up the studio so that I could preach to you, so I could testify of his power, of his might, of his glory, and he will bring it on to you. All you gotta do is want him in your heart. Ask him to come into your heart and to forgive you of your sins and wash you clean with that precious blood that he shed for all of us on the cross so long ago. On Golgotha's mountain, the mountain of the skull. Wendy, let's get to worshiping the Lord. All you people that are addicted, know that Jesus will deliver you right now. Lift up your hands right now.
You've heard a multitude of prayers on my behalf.
Jesus, save them.
And I pray one more is not too much to ask.
You told me that you would deliver them, Father.
I tried to fight this battle by myself.
Hallelujah.
But it's a war that I can't win.
words. From what I understand, he was at rehab. When he was doing that, he was at rehab, and the Lord gave him that song and caused him to bring it forth to everybody else and to bless us. I know that that song blessed you, and I know most of all that if you truly want deliverance, Jesus has delivered you right now from alcohol and drugs. Believe it, because it's true. Jesus has delivered you right now. You are delivered. You are saved. You are a child of the King's. You have been made a new creature. You will live a new life if truly you desire it from your heart. People, that I love the Lord so much, you know that I cry, you know. Ain't no biggie, you know, when I want the anointing, I cry and stuff, and my nose gets all clogged up and everything, but that's just human nature, and that's the way it is when we cry, right? But anyway, let's get back to where the Lord was, and I'm going to tell you right now, don't fear what you're going to hear. Blessed are those that read this book and hear the words that are therein. Jesus wants to get us ready because there is some terrible things coming and some terrible things. Oh my God, I think that's going to be so bad that men will seek death and death shall flee from them. In other words, those wicked people, man, that have rejected Jesus, that worship the devil and do all this bad things and all that stuff. And they'll be looking to kill themselves, and it won't matter if they cut their head off. They're not gonna die. They can hold their head out here, just like in the movies, and they'll be still crying, you know, and in torment, because they're not gonna die. But men shall seek death, and death shall flee from them. But we will not be here, because we are the children of God. We are the light of the world. We are sealed by the Holy Spirit, by the Holy Ghost. We have the name of Jesus flashing here. It says we belong to Jesus. And when those plagues come upon the wicked, oh, they'll pass us by. The Bible says that these things will not come nigh thee. And you can guarantee that Jesus is going to protect us. Those that may be left behind after the rapture to bring in those that will come out of great tribulation will be protected also to see this whole thing through until the two witnesses show up on the scene. And so on and so forth. If you know your Bible, you know that there's things to come. But Jesus doesn't have to wait for all that to be fulfilled. He's God. Come on. He's God. So he could change his mind. He can rewrite the book if he wants to. So don't be saying that, oh, I got time. I got time to go out here and whore among and just do drugs and have all this kinky sex and steal and rob and kill and molest and everything that the devil got you. You got time. No, you ain't got no time, because he's going to come for you like a thief in the night. And he ain't got to wait till he comes. He ain't come for you right now. It's time for you to turn from your wicked ways. Turn from your sin. And give it up to Jesus, and Jesus will lead you, guide you. He'll clean you up. He'll bless you, because all he wants to do is love you and bless you. I've said it before, if the devil can give these things to his children, you know, how much more will our Heavenly Father Yahweh and his Son Yeshua, Jesus of Nazareth, give unto those that love him? So we left off at the end of chapter 7, and we want to go up a little bit back into chapter 7, and we'll start back over here. Verse 11, chapter 7, where it says, and all the angels stood around about the throne, and about the elders, and the four beasts, and fell before the throne on their faces and worshiped God, saying, amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God Yahweh forever and ever, in the name of Jesus, amen. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, what are these which are arrayed in white robes, and whence came they? And I said unto him, sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they which came out of great tribulation, and have washed their robes, and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Come on and wash your robe with the blood of the Lamb. ask Jesus to save you, to fill you with the Holy Ghost, to seal you unto the day of redemption. Therefore are they before the throne of God to serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. But the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of water. And God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes. Those living fountains of water flow from beneath the throne of Yahweh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Chapter 8. And when he had opened the seventh seal, there was a silence in heaven about the space of a half an hour. And I saw the seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. And another angel came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer. There was given unto him much incense, that he should offer it up with the prayers of all the saints upon the golden altar which was before the throne of Yahweh our God. And the smoke of his incense which came with the prayers of the saints ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer and filled it with the fire of the altar and cast it into the earth, and there were voices and thunderings and lightnings, and the earth and an earthquake. And the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. The first angel sounded, and there followed hail and fire mingled with blood. And they were cast upon the earth, and the third part of the trees was burnt up, and all green grass was burnt up. And the second angel sounded, and as it were a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. That mountain that was cast burning was like a mountain burning with fire. Has to be a meteorite, a comet of sort. Oh, hallelujah. And it was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ships were destroyed. And the third angel sounded and fell a great star from heaven. And the third angel sounded and there fell a great star from heaven burning as it were a lamp. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of water. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter. But you don't have to worry about a thing, because over in Mark, the last chapter, it says that we shall drink, if we drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt us. So, you know, we can drink that water, we'll be just fine. And the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten, and the third part of the moon, and the third part of the stars, so as the third part of them was darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it, and the night likewise. And I beheld and heard an angel flying through the midst of the heavens, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels which are yet to sound. When the Bible talks about woe, man, we are in trouble, okay? But not us, but they are the ones that rejected Jesus and don't have Jesus in their heart. They have not yet asked Jesus to save their soul. They're in trouble. Those that worship Satan and sacrifice their own babies to the devil, they're in trouble. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But Jesus can save them if they only asked him to, but they won't, because they think that Satan is their God and the God of everything, and he has more power than Yahweh. But how wrong, they're wrong, because hey, Satan was cast out of heaven onto the earth. He can't live up there no more, so hey, you know what? He ain't got that much power. That's for sure.